You're watching Equatorial TV. Let's rock it.
Something is coming. Something big.
Presented by COVID-19 pandemic. Excellencies, this summit is timely because it presents an opportunity for South Sudan to reaffirm its commitment to the East African community and speaks to challenges that have affected its ability to meet its obligations to the community. The government of South Sudan to date owes the East African community membership fee arrears over the period of 2016 to 2021. The delay on payment of these arrears is not due to willful neglect. It is a result of many converging factors, namely conflict-induced economic crisis and sharp decline in oil prices, which were further aggravated by the COVID-19 pandemic. Now that we are turning a corner on stabilizing the country, I would like to appeal to the EAC's secretariat to work with my officials to restructure the amount South Sudan owes. This should be done with the goal of finding a suitable formula for installment repayment over an agreed upon period of time. If a formula for repayment of the arrears is determined, the government of South Sudan moving forward starting this year 2021 is committed to paying its membership fee without default. Indeed, and as a demonstration of our commitment to continue honoring South Sudan's financial obligations, that we shall be fully paying before the end of this year. Excellencies, one of the key plans of the East African community vision is free movement of people and goods. It is on this vision of our region that I am appealing for a visa waiver, particularly between South Sudan on one hand and Kenya and Uganda on the other. I believe it is on our best interest to ease the movement of people and goods within the region. Doing so will facilitate trade, investment, as well as contribute to our end goal of East African regional integration. On the same point, I would like to update this summit on the status of South Sudan joining the East African Community, the East African Custom Union. In 2016, South Sudan agreed to finally or to fully implement AEC Custom Union by 2019. We were not able to meet this deadline due to combination of factors. Alluded to earlier in my remarks, which hampered our preparations to undertake sophisticated reforms required before joining the East African Custom Union. To this effect, South Sudan appeals for additional capacity development support, especially to its National Revenue Authority from East African Community structures to fast track joining the custom unions in the near future. Excellencies, as the term of office of the EAC Secretary General ends, South Sudan, whose turn is to nominate a candidate for this rotational position, has deferred its nomination to the position and instead supports the nominee from the Republic of Kenya for the position. This decision came as a result of background discussions with the regional counterparts and after assurances that South Sudan will assume the position after the term of the incoming candidate for the EAC Secretary General ends.